Heartily welcome to all the delegates, those who have taken part here. Good morning to all of you again. I would like to convey my heartfelt thanks to EQ International Group. Hopefully, I think Mr. Anand Gupta and this team might have conducted hundreds of meetings and conferences like this across the country. More than doing the business, more than investing, we need the supporting factor, moral support like these events through the medias like EQ International. There are so many other people entered in this space, but I believe EQ stands first. So they are also in the solar field. I know their group, I know them. I know what about the talents, how they are going on, keep on happening national and international level. So I would like to congratulate this group for this today's event to be held in Bangalore. At the same time, I would like to request them to have some programs like this to create the awareness among the developers in Tamil Nadu. Mr. Anand Gupta, Tamil Nadu is not an untouchable part to you. So I would like to request you to come and do something in Tamil Nadu. Hope during the concluding section, he will give some of the dates to do something in Tamil Nadu. Hopefully, I would like to welcome again all of you, sir. The top-level people, those we gather here on the dais and as well as the people in front of us, really, it makes a lot of impression how we are progressing towards the achievable target of Narendra Modi ji's of 100 gigawatt to this country. Sir, all we know very well, we are blessed with 300 sunny days. And as well as southern part also, after Gujarat and Rajasthan, Andhra, Karnataka, Tamil Nadu, we are having a good sunny days. And the attraction for this sector, as earlier I might have told by Mr. Santosh, after BJP came to power, after Narendra Modi assumed as the Prime Minister of India, and Mr. P.S. Goyal has taken up the portfolio of MNRE, and as well as the stalwarts like earlier Tripathi and as well as Tarun Kapoor, all these team, including Akshay Kumar, Ashwini Kumar of SECI, they are the architects for this country to bring this country as a heading for International Solar Alliance. We are proud of that. We are proud of Prime Minister and as well as for bringing International Solar Alliance to this country. Of course, this needs lot of efforts, lot of influence, lot of support from government. As rightly my colleague Ms. Santosh might have told you what is happening in China. It's all not at all comparable. What China is doing, what we are doing. To bring this kind of policy, to take up this country towards the 100 gigawatt target, it has taken a lot of time for us. Policies are created by government and the rulers, and it is implemented by the bureaucrats and the government authorities. And then finally, where it is going to end up to develop the project is by the banker. Hopefully somebody, some of the people came from banker side also, hopefully State Bank, other banks, they might have taken part here. They are the key people to support this project because they are the people having money. Every one of the developer, every one of the firm, those who wants to enterprise into solar, they have to live under the mercy of the banker today. That is the scenario in this country, whether you accept it or not. So, first of all, my step, my request to bankers, consider the projects under priority scheme. Ms. Santoshi knows, when we won 100 megawatts recently in Tamil Nadu as a 3.47, the lowest bid of Tamil Nadu, how the bankers are pulling us pillar to post. I'm sorry to mention this dais. I am having the politics that is not doing anything in business. I don't want to mix up politics into business. It's a different concept. If you mix up, you are out on the day. Bureaucrats may not like, bankers may not like, even the business people also may not like. But having both, how we have to survive in this country, this is what before us. We need politics as pickle in the leaf of the food. At the same time, main food is from business, the same policy we are also following. Many people might have thought that he is an XMP, he might have a lot of money made in politics. No. We are making money purely in business and spending money in politics. Santoshi knows, everybody knows of me. So with this concept to grow under the democratic system, Today, why we haven't chosen solar? We are into IT, we are into insurance. Today, we are into solar nearly about 4 years. The first 701 of the tariff won by us in Tamil Nadu, unfortunately, for the various political reasons, we could not sign the PPAs. It's a different thing. At the same time, we were waiting for the opportunity to see that what is the reasonable tariff going to get for us is 3.47 in Tamil Nadu, which is still on the higher side of Gujarat and Rajasthan when you compare the Rewa Park or Bhadla Park or wherever it is, other parts of the country. Of course, as everybody knows that Tamil Nadu may have some kind of other constraints like political instability, little bit corruption, some scams. Today it's all getting vanished because the government of India is directly watching what is happening in the state of Tamil Nadu into solar and the renewable energy sector. Recently, Tamil Nadu joined in the Uday scheme with the support of Mr. Fees Goyal. Tangedco was a debt-oriented organization. Today, it is getting converted into profit-making organization. And in Tamil Nadu, today, we are getting the support of the tariff to be honored with healthy at the end of the day. Whether they are honest or dishonest, God only knows. But today, what is available? This is the part of Tamil Nadu. Coming to Karnataka, where I partly live in Bangalore, my place is 1 hour journey from here, Krishnagiri and Hosur. I like Karnataka, I love Karnataka. It is not because my mother belongs to Karnataka or my children are living here. Here, the atmosphere is good. Here, the leaders are good. Whether they belong to BJP, whether they belong to Congress, whether they belong to JDS. Of course, beyond all of these things, we are seeing the political stability in Karnataka. So we welcome every of the entrepreneur, every of the proposed entrepreneur to come down and do something into solar and renewable energy sector in Karnataka. The policies are very friendly. The regulators are very friendly. The politicians are approachable and accessible. And it is the doable things are there. So we welcome all of you to do something in Karnataka, sir. Of course, my friend D.K. Sivakumar is not here. Of course, our friend Siddaramaiah is supporting. They keep on handling, they keep on conducting various conferences and programs. So in spite of that, I could say that Karnataka wants 3,000 megawatts of the Pavagada Park, which is quite attractive in the southern part of the country. Of course, Chandrababu Naidu is trying to bypass. It is happening because of their own visions. But Karnataka, we have a stable policy. They have a good people. They have got good rulers. And everybody is friendly. People are not only friendly, the administrators are also friendly. That's why all we like Karnataka. So you people are blessed with all these things. Whereas in other states, it's not like that. I was there in Rajasthan 1.5 months back. The Chief Minister Madam asked me, Narsimhan ji, why can't you do something in Rajasthan? I asked them to allocate some kind of land for the projects. She said, already many people signed, somebody has run away and some people are keeping the land, they are not doing anything. Today we are crossroads, we are at the crossroads. What happened for the past 3 years into solar, 3.5 years into solar is different. Now currently what we are facing, the situation into solar is totally different because it is not only for the, it is not because of the policy. It is because of the situation, the circumstances happened to hamper little bit growth of the solar projects. That's why we insist from the day one, everybody knows, under the Indian Solar Association, we given various representation to government and as well as the state governments. Still we are insisting them, the major hampering is even because of low-cost funding is not at all accessible and available. Other than the various big groups, all other entrepreneurs, they have to live under the mercy of the nationalized or any kind of bankers. We got REC, we have got IRIDA, we have got PFC, we have got other organizations to support us beyond the bankers, exclusively for the renewable energy in this country. But in spite of all these institutions, I am not telling this to discourage you. I want to create the awareness among the developers.
So,
in spite of all these things. Yeah.
So, financing is one thing, sir, for sure, as you pointed out.
I will come back.
What about the policy and the other side?
Yeah, I'm coming there. In spite of all these things, I am requesting the government of India to create an exclusive bank with the low-cost funding available for the developers, whether it should be named as the Renewable Energy Bank or Green Bank. We have got SIDBI for what? Small Industries Organization. We got IDBI exclusively for what? For the industrial development. Today we have nothing for this other than these four institutions, where the rate of interest is always talked about 9.5% to 11%. So here also, I would request to all the panelists to finalize a resolution insisting government of India to announce an exclusive bank for solar energy projects at the low cost funding, which should not exceed more than 6% to 7% to compete in the world. This is the one. Regarding the policy, there we, from the day one, we are talking about the policy. Each and every state government have their own wishes and willingness. Tamil Nadu says, I will support through LC. Karnataka says, I am honoring all the payments in time. And many of the payments are delayed and deferred by various other states. This is because of the DISCOMs' failure of their credit position. They are not so stronger to honor the PPAs. So what we look forward is a viable PPA, bankable PPA. It should be honored by the payers, DISCOMs. It should be supported by the financial institution. More than that, what we need is a proper policy. The policy-wise, we are insisting the government of India, sir, we should have a uniform policy throughout the country. Every state, one policy, one price, one payment mechanism, one discount mechanism. This is not proper. It is creating in among the international investors, it is creating some plus and minus. They got a lot of confusions. Yesterday, we had a talk with our Norway guys. Some of the Norway company has invested 197 megawatts day four yesterday into Malaysia. When I was in Malaysia, when I was in Norway, I could see what is happening here and there. But when we invite India, what they talk, political stability is there, but the policies are differ from state to state. So I would like to request and honor India should have a uniform policy according to radiation available throughout the country. Maybe region-wise, it may be 1% or 2% difference. So we should have a government of India uniform policy throughout the country, one tariff, bankable tariff. That policy should be friendly, avoiding all the constraints of the land banks, grid connectivity, financial support, and as well as coming again the bankable PPAs, and to give all the support exclusively for the solar energy people. Beyond all these things, Ms. Santosh has requested to conclude the speech, but with one point, let me conclude. We are trying to bring an exclusive insurance coverage for all the solar developers in this country. The coverage is for the generation guarantee, which is going to affect us beyond, it is by the natural calamities. Suppose Karnataka is blessed with 300 sunny days, the projections given to bank, the projections given by the developer and to the government is for based on this. Anything goes beyond our control by natural calamities. Every day we are seeing rainy season here. Every day we are seeing more cloudy. With this kind of effects, the generation will be getting affected. To cover this, in this country, if you have anything, even the farmers, if they lose the crop because of the natural calamity, they are covered. So we are advising the government to bring the solar exclusive insurance policy for the generation guarantee as well as for the support from the natural calamities. This will be happening after some time. Ms. Santosh knows, everybody knows well, we are working very aggressively for this. I hope Karnataka, out of 7,000 or 6,000 megawatt they expected, they have done slightly more than 1/4 of that. With all these things, Karnataka is progressing very much because of the supportive policies. Still, if there are any constraints, if there are any loopholes, if there are any more demands, I request all the panelists to prepare a memorandum which we can give it to Honorable Chief Minister and Power Minister of the state, and we can work together to support this. Sir, with all these things, solar is the only best projects where people even at the stage of the retirement also can have a look on this, because this is only going to give you the revenues like a fixed deposit for several years, 25 years like that. So I would like to welcome all of you, and as well as to listen to all of you. Let us create something in Karnataka. Let us work together for the progress of the solar energy in Karnataka. Let us bring good revenues to the state and good employment to the state. With the support of skill development departments, definitely Karnataka can look into that. Karnataka can look into more in the manufacturing sector. Already there are some companies manufacturing in a better way, which I would like to request the Karnataka government through this dais to create a value chain from polysilicon to cell and panel with a 1 gigawatt size, at least to cater the requirements of the southern part of India. So we need to encourage the manufacturing sector. We need to bring the solar insurance. We need to bring the low cost funding. We need to bring the wonderful policies. Karnataka will pioneer in this. We will take the support of all the rulers. We'll go ahead, sir. Thank you very much for giving this opportunity. If I've taken more time, I'm very sorry for this. I can interact with you again and again. We want to see that India is going to achieve 100 gigawatts at the time prescribed by Honorable Prime Minister Modi ji, and we would be taking part in the International Solar Alliance as a future stakeholders, as a future participants. I would like to welcome all of you to reach this goal. Thank you very much.